Keith Kay, time to make that year-end video. Time to get it over with. 2017 has a few more days left, but it's too damn cold to go hunt. I want to make this short, so let's get it on with it. That thing in front of you, that's the troll. The troll knows who he is. Hey, troll, thanks for watching over my coins. Here we go. I put this together because these are things I like to talk about. These are things you find, you bring them home, and they're actually kind of a treasure. The rings, all to this side, various 925, various sterling, and then you get that ring. I can't tell if it's real or not. I have to take it to a jeweler. I have a jeweler's loop, and I can't even read the imprint on the inside of that ring. Wouldn't that be nice? Gold with diamonds. Oh, my goodness. There you go, an earring. I think that's gold. I want to tell you about Coinstar. I put this silver aside. This is Coinstar silver. People dump their coins in. They don't check the reject box. And they leave a silver dollar sitting in the reject box of Coinstar. If you get a chance, people, dip into those Coinstars. Look at this. I was once a school crossing guard. That's a cool tag to have. Here's something, you dig it up, and that's got a date of 1500. I don't think that's just a picture or something. I don't think it was from the 1500s. Radio Orphan Annie. That's an awesome find. If you know anything about Orphan Annie back in the 40s, always on the radio, and you sent in your information and you joined the club, that number can probably be tied to some little girl or guy who listened to Orphan Annie. There's another thing. Sunoco car tokens. These are cool to find. I like them. Silver in a way of religious medallions. I find a few every year. This thing looks gold, but it's not. Here's a dog tag. You could actually send it right back to the guy who owned the dog. The dog's name was Cookie. Here's a tag also. 19, is that 24? Yes, 34. That's pretty old dog tag. And here's another one where it's good for one ride on the trolley. Anyhow, you get these kinds of finds, you walk off saying, hey, I had a pretty good day out there. Stand by, we'll show you some silver now. Keith Kay, I had a goal this year of 73 silvers. I ended up with 75. My year didn't get started until April 1st. I had a few months of radiation treatments to get past and then get on my way. But once I was on my way, I started collecting some silver. The year is kind of weird because the coins changed dramatically. Right here, Roosevelt's. 36 of them. Over here, Barber's. 5 of them. Mercury's, 7 of them. The Mercs, I used to get more Mercs than Roosevelt's. Something changed about that. Hey, quarters. No Barber quarters this year. But I did get seated. Stand by. I have 17 Washingtons. I have a couple of war nickels. Go up here. I wish I could have got it on the live deck. I didn't have my camera with me. But I knew it was something big under there. And I pulled this peace dollar. They're awesome. That's my second peace dollar I've ever dug. I've been at this for 6 years. I have 2 Morgans and a peace. And now I got a Canadian dollar too. So anyhow, here's a cool coin. A 3 pence. Silver 3 pence. 40% Kennedy. Canadian dime. And this here's a Mexican. Just Republic of Mexico. And there's the prize. There's the coin we all look for. This is the bucket lister as far as a silver quarter is concerned. I think it's awesome. And when you get one of these, you feel so good. Let's take a look at it. 18. What is it, 76? I've looked at it dozens of times, and I still forget the year. It's not in bad shape at all. When I turned it over, I was ecstatic. Anyhow, that's the coin that made my year. The bucket lister. Any silver coins that I find, I'm glad to have. Glad to have. Any of this stuff I find, I'm glad to have. I'm just glad to be out there. Let me mention a couple people who hunt with me. Silver Sue. She's found a few of them out there with me. Dr. Zed, his yearly total was 242 silvers. His best silver find was a capped bust dime. Awesome coin. He found it more or less where he lives, not here in the city of Pittsburgh. But anyhow, look forward to seeing us again in 2018. I'm going to have the troll. Just keep watching over this stuff. And, hey, I'll get back to you. Thank you for subscribing to Detecting the Burgh. And let's all have a very good 2018. Stand by.